Hello everyone, and this is video number 29, and today we will be doing grammar, and the lesson is pronouns. So we are only going to revise this lesson because I think that you know what is pronoun and you have done this lesson in your previous class also. So what is pronoun? Pronoun is a word used instead of a noun. So what is pronoun? A pronoun is a word used instead of a noun. See, pronouns make it easier to read and speak. Just imagine how boring it would sound if we had to write or say the nouns repeatedly. So pronoun is a word used instead of a noun. For example, Ajay is ill, so he is absent today. Ajay is ill, so he is absent today. So here in this example, you can see that he is used instead of Ajay. Ajay is noun and he is pronoun used instead of Ajay. Now we will deal with types of pronoun. Okay, types of pronoun. So pay attention. What are the types of pronoun? First one is personal pronoun. What is personal pronoun? Personal pronoun is used in place of names of people, places and things. So personal pronoun is used in place of names of people, places and things. Now see, again, personal pronoun is divided into two parts. We have subject pronouns and we have object pronouns. Subject, what is subject pronouns? Subject pronouns used as subject in sentences. I, you, she, he, we, it and they. So see, when these pronouns are used as a subject in a sentence, then they are known as subject pronoun. Okay. Next, object pronoun used as object in sentences. Example, me, you, him, her, them, us and it. We use me, you, him, her, them, us and it as a object in a sentence, and so they are known as object pronoun. Now it will be clear with the help of example. Okay, see the example. I live near a school. So see, I is a pronoun and I is subject pronoun because I am using I as a subject in a sentence. He is going home. He is pronoun and he is subject pronoun. Next, object pronoun we have done. So let's see the example of object pronoun. Our grandparents live with us. Okay, our grandparents live with us. Now see, us. Us is object pronoun because us is used as a object in the sentence. So, us is object pronoun. Sohan bought a gift for him. Him is again used as an object. It is not used as a subject. So, him is an object pronoun. Okay. So, what we have done? We have done what is pronoun. Pronoun is a word that is used instead of noun. Then we have done types of pronoun. The first one was personal pronoun. Now, we will do, after personal pronoun, we have demonstrative pronoun. What is demonstrative pronouns? Used to point out specific persons, animals, places, things or ideas. So demonstrative pronoun will be pointing out specific, that is particular person, animals, places, things or ideas. And what is demonstrative pronoun? Example of demonstrative pronoun is this, that, these and those. Okay. Example, that is my pen. So that is demonstrative pronoun. Those are our paintings. Those is demonstrative pronoun. Possessive pronouns. Possessive pronouns used to indicate possession. Possession means to whom it belongs. So possessive pronoun used to indicate possessions. It indicates to whom it belongs. Examples, mine, yours, his, hers, theirs, ours, and its. Example, if this isn't ours, it must be theirs. So see, ours and theirs is possessive pronoun. Yours is much better than mine. Yours is possessive pronoun and mine is possessive pronoun because they both are indicating possession. Interrogative pronoun. It is very clear and interrogative pronoun is very easy also. Integrative pronoun used to begin or introduce interrogative sentences. So interrogative pronoun will be used to ask question. Used to begin or introduce interrogative sentences. Example, WH words, okay? Who, whom, whose, what, and which. Examples, whom did you invite for the lecture? See, whom is interrogative pronoun. What did you like best? What is interrogative pronoun? So till now, what we have done? We have done pronouns. What is pronoun? Pronoun is a word used instead of noun. Then we have done types of pronoun. First one was personal pronoun. Okay. First one was personal pronoun. Next was demonstrative pronoun. Third is possessive pronoun. And the fourth is interrogative pronoun. Before I deal with other kinds of pronoun, what we will do? We will do a exercise which is based on the pronouns which I taught you right now. Okay? And then I will proceed to other pronouns which are emphatic pronoun, reflexive pronoun, and relative pronoun. So let's do an exercise first. Okay, this one. Fill in the blanks with suitable pronouns. Fill in the blanks with suitable pronouns. Blank is a beautiful painting. You can write, this is a beautiful painting, or it is a beautiful painting. Blank is my house over there. That is my house over there. My name is Lata. Blank loves singing. I love singing. Blank is that person. So you have to fill it with interrogative pronoun and the answer will be, who is that person? Is this your purse? I am pretty sure it is yours. This is possessive pronoun. So see, 8 questions are there. From 1 to 5, I have told you the answers. Rest, I want you to try it yourself and write down the answers. Okay? Okay, so 1 to 5 I have told you, rest you can do it yourself, and exercise A everyone will do in copy. So exercise A everyone has to do it in copy. Let's move to next pronoun. What is the next pronoun? Next pronoun is emphatic pronoun. What is this emphatic pronoun? Read this sentence. Aditi and Deep made the arrangements themselves. Here the word themselves shows that only Aditi and Deep did the work and they did it on their own. It is used to emphasize. Emphasize means to lay stress. It is used to emphasize the nouns in the sentence. Such a word is called an emphatic pronoun. Here is another example. She made the doll model herself. In this sentence, herself emphasizes the pronoun she. So, emphatic pronoun is used to emphasize the nouns in the sentence. It will lay stress on the nouns in the sentence. Okay. Example, Aditi and Deep made the arrangements themselves. So, what you are seeing that this Aditi and Deep have made the arrangement themselves, and this themselves is emphasizing Aditi and Deep. So, emphatic pronoun is used to emphasize the nouns in sentences. Okay? The definition is, emphatic pronouns emphasize a noun or another noun in the same sentence. They typically end with self or selves. They typically end with self or selves. So, emphatic pronoun is used to emphasize a noun or another pronoun in the same sentence. It will only lay stress on the noun and the pronoun. And mostly you will see that it will end with self or selves. Now, what are the examples of emphatic pronoun? Myself, yourself, himself, herself, itself, oneself, ourselves, themselves, and yourselves. Okay. Next one is reflexive pronoun. What is reflexive pronoun? Read this sentence. Ruma saw herself in the mirror. Now see, herself was reflecting back to Ruma. Ruma saw herself in the mirror. What is the subject here? The subject is Ruma. Ruma is the subject. And what is the object? Yes, here the object is herself. We learn that Ruma saw herself and no one else in the mirror. The word herself is used to point back to the noun in the sentences. Such a pronoun is called reflexive pronoun. So see, when the pronoun is used to point back to the noun in the sentence, it will be known as reflexive pronoun. Means it will turn back to the noun. So the pronoun which will turn back to the noun, the pronoun which you will point back to the noun will be known as reflexive pronoun. Let's look at another example. He bought himself a new game. Now see this, himself is turning back to he. So himself will be reflexive pronoun because himself is again pointing to he. So himself will be reflexive pronoun. In this sentence, himself points back to the pronoun he. I told you, see, when the pronoun will be laying stress on the noun or the pronoun, then it will be known as emphatic pronoun. But when the pronoun will be turning back to the noun, when it will be turning back to the pronoun, what will happen? It will be known as reflexive pronoun. Reflexive pronouns are used when the doer of an action also receives the action. Okay, so the doer is the receiver of the action in reflexive pronoun. Now, let us do some exercises related to emphatic pronoun and reflexive pronoun. Examples of emphatic pronoun and reflexive pronoun will be same. Again, in reflexive pronoun also you will see what are the examples: myself, himself, herself, itself, yourself, ourselves, and themselves are reflexive pronoun. So you have to read the sentence and then you have to find out that whether it is emphatic pronoun or whether it is reflexive pronoun. What will be the difference? You will see that in emphatic pronoun, what will happen? The pronoun will lay stress on the noun. And in reflexive pronoun, what will happen? The pronoun will turn back to the noun or the pronoun. And in this way, you can find out that whether it is reflexive or whether it is emphatic. Let's see, it will be clear with the help of this exercise. This exercise also is important, exercise B. Everyone, please do exercise B in copy. I will be discussing some of the answers. identify whether the highlighted pronouns are reflexive or emphatic. Ritu hurt herself. So now it what will be this? Reflexive or emphatic? See, herself is turning back to Ritu. Herself is pointing back to the noun. So herself will be reflexive pronoun. Understood? See second sentence. I myself finished the work. Now see, this myself is emphasizing I. Myself is used to emphasize I. I is pronoun, and I told you when the pronoun will be used to emphasize, that means to lay stress on the noun or the pronoun, it will be known as emphatic pronoun. So myself will be emphatic pronoun. My father himself created this dish. You tell me what it will be. See, my father himself. Okay, so again this himself is used to lay stress on my father. Himself is emphasizing my father. So himself will be emphatic pronoun. Number 4. They completed the project themselves. Okay, they completed the project themselves. Now see, easy way I am telling you how you can find out. Do you think that this themselves is used after project? So do you think that this themselves is emphasizing project? No, themselves is emphasizing they. They completed the project themselves. So them here themselves will be emphatic pronoun. Sudhir hurt himself in the Cave of Echoes. Himself. Himself is pointing back to the noun. Himself is turning back to the noun. That is Sudhir. So himself will be reflexive pronoun. See, I have discussed from 1 to 5. There are altogether 8 questions are given. Okay. You try other questions and do it. So exercise B also please complete in your copy. Now the last one. Last one is relative pronoun. Okay, what is relative pronoun? This is the last one, relative pronoun. Okay. Read what Raghu has to say about a new video game. The new app that we downloaded is very interesting. Our friend who suggested it was sure we would enjoy it. In the first sentence, the word that comes after the noun app, okay, and introduces a set of words linking them to the noun. Similarly, in the second sentence, who introduce a set of words and link them to the subject, our friends. Here who and that are relative pronoun. So see in this sentence, the new app. App is a noun and that is being used as a connector. And after this that, we that is used to link a set of words. So that is relative pronoun. Here also our friend. Friend, our friend is noun and our friend is the subject. And after that we have used who. Who is a relative pronoun and who is again linking a set of the words to our friend. Now let's see what will be the definition of relative pronoun. A relative pronoun comes after. See, what is the definition of relative pronoun? A relative pronoun comes after a noun to point to it or to give more information about it. So a relative pronoun will always come after a noun and to point to it or to give more information about it. Examples of relative pronoun: who, whoever, whose, which, whichever, that, what, and whatever are relative pronouns. Fill in the correct pronouns from those given in bracket. I saw a car. I wondered blank it was. What will be the answer? Whose or that? The answer will be, I saw a car, I wondered whose it was. Where is the DVD? Blank, Rohit bought last week. Where is the DVD that Rohit bought last week? Okay. This is the house, blank, we moved into last year. This is the house that we moved into last year. My cousin, blank, lives in Bangalore, is coming today. What will be the correct answer? That or who? My cousin who lives in Bangalore is coming today. The man, blank, is standing at the gate is my father. So what you will use? Who or which? Of course you will use who. The man who is standing at the gate is my father. Okay. So exercise C also you will do in copy. So you will do exercise A, B and C in copy. Thank you.